You're not doing an orange theory class, you're not going to gain strength. Like, you're really not.
What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel.
I'm eating
one of my favorite things.
3 slices of turkey bacon, 2 slices of toast, and some egg whites with some sea salt
to fuel up for the gym. It's about 10:15 right now in the morning, and I've actually been up since 4 a.m. Not because like I wanted to, it was just because I kind of woke up at 4 a.m. and I couldn't fall back asleep, and then around like 6-ish, I decided to start being productive and edit a vlog that I'm trying to get up today and things like that. But I have something exciting happened today that I wanna share with you guys, and that's one of the reasons why I decided to vlog, but we will get there. It has something to do with a haircut that's happening a little bit later in this video, so just stay tuned. I also just signed up my first client for November. It's only October 12th, which is awesome, because sometimes I sign up people like later in the month, or like in the middle of the month, or in the beginning, and obviously like I just rather secure spots sooner. Like, I would rather be able to close up coaching instead of like waiting till the end of the month, like seeing like, okay, any more clients wanna sign up? You know what I mean? So. Okay, hi, I'm ready for the gym, and I'm kind of shocked that it's already legging season. Snuck up on me, but yeah, I have this matching set on from Fabletics. It's like from a while ago, so I don't think you can buy it now or anything like that, but I love it. And then for my sneakers I have on Nobles, I do need to order a new pair, but I don't know. I like always wear my gym sneakers till they're like falling apart. So yeah, does anyone else do that? I don't know. Some people are like real sneakerheads when it comes to the gym. I like sneakers. You guys listen to my next podcast episode that's going up. It's going to be the second podcast episode. You will hear some insight into like what it's like working on social media and like what I choose to spend my money on and things like that. So, because I don't have like a salaried job, it's different for me. So like, I'm not gonna spend like my money on sneakers. Like, but anyways, you guys gotta listen to that podcast. If you guys aren't already subscribed to my podcast, please do. You can listen to it on Spotify. I haven't listened to it on Apple, but like it takes a few days to like get up there. Spotify, it's definitely on there. So you can follow, subscribe, and I have an Instagram for it. I just need to start posting more on it. But it's been really cool to do a podcast. It's definitely different than vlogging, and I'm sharing so much more of my life, like personal life on there, I think, because it's so much easier to just like get those up in a timely manner. So it's like vlogs, like for example, it is October 12th today. The vlog that I'm about to upload today, I'm pretty sure I filmed it like 2.5 weeks ago. Do you know what I mean? But the podcast is gonna be every week. Anyways, let's go to the gym and get our lift in. My name came up a lot of sounds, more when I was not around. Certain people that I know, they no longer about. Unless you heard it from me, then you ain't heard it from me. Got it from me, all the energy extra. Walking. However, I can only walk for like 20 minutes because I'm about to get my haircut here at my apartment. And the way it works is we have this app that you can just book a hairdresser the same way you can like book an Uber, and then they just come to this apartment, and we have a room that has like a sink and a mirror and everything that you need to like
do somebody's hair, they obviously come and bring their products and things like that, and then like you just pay them through the app and then of course like tip them. And since my hair is super simple, like I just get a trim and a face frame and I like to keep it long, I feel like most people like can cut it, you know what I mean? So I'm excited to try out a new hairdresser. I'm gonna meet someone new. I actually just saw her while I was in the gym because the gym and the glam room are like connected to each other. So she was walking in at like 12 o'clock. So I wanna shower really quick. I'm not gonna wash my hair. And I'm gonna leave my mascara on because it's kind of really annoying for me to take off my mascara. It really is like a process. So I usually just like wash around my eyes, but I will wash my whole body and change my outfit. And then of course she'll wash my hair. Was it the voice? Was it the fire burning in me? All of the noise turned into choirs of harmony. All right, so freshly showered. I did keep my hair in, like you guys saw. I just tied up these two braids so they didn't get wet while I was in the shower washing my body. I washed my face and then redid my face makeup and didn't touch my mascara though because, like I said, didn't want to mess it up. This dress is actually from Amazon. I'll have it linked on my page if you guys want to get it. It's so comfortable. I'm wearing a size small. Like, I need to order more colors. I love dresses because they're so simple and easy. You just throw them on. And then, of course, my sneakers are Fila's and my socks are Nike. My appointment is at 1 o'clock and it's like 12:51, so I'm about to head down. And I'm so excited to finally get my hair cut because it's been way too long.
Hi, how are you? Oh
my gosh, I'm so excited.
I'm Emily, by the way.
Love my hair so much. I like can't stop smiling. It's so healthy now. Also, I was cold, so I like just threw this sweatshirt on. If you guys have been following my journey for a while, you already know that I have done Orangetheory for years. Literally, I started it in 2017. I was a college athlete, and it was perfect for me because I did a lot of running as a midfielder, played lacrosse, and it just helped me stay in shape because I hated running. So it was my senior year of college is when I kind of discovered it. Technically, the summer leading up to it, I had an apartment, and they built one right across from the apartment that I was living at. So it was literally 4 minutes for me to get in my car, get over there, and get out of the car. Like, that's how close I was. So I think convenience played a huge role into why I loved going, along with it being my first ever group exercise-oriented environment aside from all the sports that I played. And I thought it was just such a cool thing to be a part of because I know that being an athlete, it always just placed me on a sports team, always had sporty friends around me. But as you become an adult, you wanna like learn how to make other friends, and it was perfect for me to make friends and stay around like-minded people. And I think that it's really great for that. And there are benefits to doing that that never end in general of like a group exercise class. Like, just being around another group of people while you're working out, following the same workout, pushing one another, there's nothing that compares. Personally, in my life right now, I don't do that, but we're not talking about that. I am going to start taking classes here at my apartment, though. Scarcely. They only offer them, like, twice a day, and so I just gotta
it's a matter of me getting to the class. Like, I completely keep forgetting. It was 2017 when I started and 2021 when I officially ended it. It's been 1 month since I haven't had my membership. I honestly haven't even been going though for like probably 2 months. And the biggest thing that I wanna say that while I was doing Orange Theory, I constantly felt like I was working super duper hard and not seeing any results. And it wasn't until I switched over to Prime Intensity Training, which is a group exercise training place where I used to live. Like, I don't live near there anymore, and that's why I stopped going there as well. I don't live near them, and I'm not gonna drive out of the city just to go do a workout class. Like, it doesn't make sense. Like, I moved to the city to be here in the city. I have noticed like some other group exercise environments, but I also pay to be living in a place that has a gym right underneath me. And I feel like there comes a point where you need to just take responsibility and realize that there's only so much other people can do for you, and you need to be able to do things yourself. And I'm at a point where I don't want to feel like I rely on anyone but myself to get results. And so I'm working through that, and I can't give advice and help other people with their strength training journey and things of that nature until I, you know, put myself through my own journey. And I love sharing my journey with everyone. I just shared my Orange Theory journey for a very long time, and now I'm slowly transitioning into, you know, just bodybuilding typed workouts. I don't want to be a bodybuilder. I don't want to step on stage or do a show, but I do have goals of like, you know, I want to be able to squat over 200 pounds by myself. That's a big goal, considering right now I can do like 135 on my own. You know, I am 25 right now, so there's really no like limit on your fitness journey, which is something that I love. And so I feel like in the next couple of years, it's possible for me to work towards where I wanna be through progressive overload and strength training. Now, not everyone has the goal of being able to squat 200 pounds and just to be able to do strong things in general. Some people just want functional fitness, and if that's what you're looking for, Orange Theory is great for you. If you want muscle definition and you want to see changes in your body, Orange Theory is not for you. It's not worth it. If you're someone who wants to get into working out, or maybe you haven't worked out in a really long time, do Orange Theory to get yourself started so you can get back in shape. But once you're in shape and you are, you know, up and running, get out of there and just go do strength training if you want muscle definition. If you don't want muscle definition and you just want to have fun in your workout, do some resistance training for your muscles, but you don't actually want to grow your muscles, do Orange Theory. If you want to grow your muscles, if you want to see changes, then you should probably stop, because they will not come. Unless you do like the Lift 45 classes, that could be something that helps, but there's so many studios that don't even have them, or they had them and they took them away. And I'm not bashing Orange Theory. I'm just trying to tell people that, you know, I did it for so many years thinking that it would give me results, but it didn't give me results. I just stayed like plateaued, like I didn't see changes, and that's just the truth of it. I only started seeing changes when I started working out at Prime Intensity Training. And for the last like 2 years, I really was mainly doing Prime Intensity Training, which was literally strength training based. And I did Orange Theory once a week, twice a week, just to film it for my YouTube channel. I wasn't even really like doing my best in the workouts. It was like I was showing up to Orange Theory just to film, and I really didn't even want to be there. I didn't even think the workout was good or effective, and I was just doing it for the views. And obviously you guys can tell I get no views now that I don't post about Orange Theory, and that just is what it is. But I'm here to say, depending on what your goals are, you might want to move away from doing Orange Theory. I don't think a lot of people watching this video will actually quit Orange Theory and leave Orange Theory. I also don't even think you should quit Orange Theory completely. I'm just saying maybe you should do it once a week or twice a week, and then 2 days a week, 3 days a week, strength train, you know? And if you don't even know where to start with strength training, I tell my one-on-one clients to create 2 workouts for themselves, one upper body day, one lower body day, of the exercises that they like, doing 3 to 4 rounds with, you know, 10 to 15 reps, starting out with a little bit lower weight and progressive overloading, and continuously doing those exercises to see results. Right now, I lift 4 to 5 days a week. My goal is 5 days a week. I definitely always do four because I do 2 lower body days and 2 upper body days. And if I do lift on the 5th day, it's another lower body day. So my goal is 3 lower body days and 2 upper body days. And I've been repeating this workout set every single week, making sure I'm focusing on what weights I'm using, keeping good form. You don't just bump up in weights every single week. You sometimes get stuck at the same weight for a while, but that just means like work on your form and getting stronger. And you know, obviously at the very end, you wanna up your weights and really give that failure, because that's what's gonna help you, you know, grow those muscles is when you're going to failure. But if you're not going to failure, people, which you're not doing an Orangetheory class, you're not going to gain strength. Like, you're really not. And the reason you saw results when you first started is probably because you weren't working out at all. Like, maybe you were walking or you were running. And so then once you started Orangetheory and you started doing, you know, just any resistance training, you obviously started seeing those newbie gains and the growth right away. But I am following people that, you know, do Orangetheory, and I'm just watching their journey and watching their journey, and they just, you know, I'm not anyone, you're not supposed to judge anyone else's journey, but I'm just saying, some people would benefit from changing their style of workouts to strength training. Like I said, for the last 2 years, I've been doing strength training focused, not the same kind that I'm doing now on my own. Before, I didn't do any machines and I didn't lift 4 to 5 days a week. You also have to make sure that you're eating enough. So right now I'm eating a little bit more because I'm trying to build muscle, and it is kind of uncomfortable, but right now I'm trying to gain muscle. So if you want to gain muscle, you have to be eating enough. There's a lot of factors that go into gaining muscle and everything like that. But I'm just saying, if you started Orangetheory when you literally weren't doing anything else similar to that, like, yes, you're going to see results right away. The first 2 years of Orangetheory were great. Then I started feeling like, okay, not really getting anywhere. Once I started implementing strength training, that's what changed the game. So overall, do I think it's worth it? I think it's worth it for a certain amount of time in your fitness journey. I think it's worth it depending on your goal. Are you a college athlete? Are you trying to run a marathon? I think that it really depends on your goal. If your goal is to have muscle definition, to look shredded, to increase your metabolic rate so you can eat more just by existing because you have more muscle on your body, no, it's not worth it to continue to do Orangetheory for years and years and years and years and years and years and years. It is not. If you want results, you need to do progressive overload. That's how you're going to change your body. Am I an expert? No. Did I do Orangetheory for over 5 years? Yes. I'm just telling you guys the facts, and it costs a lot of money. So I just don't want anyone out there that is actually really trying to, you know, get those abs or get that muscle definition to think that they can attain it through this cardio-based class for years on end. And in fact, it can cause injuries. Some of my clients have so many injuries because they're doing Orangetheory like 5 to 7 days a week. And I'm like, you know, it doesn't matter how much you're running, that's not going to, you know, give you the abs. The abs won't appear if you don't have them there. And the only way to get abs is to do things like, you know, toes to bar, weighted crunches, barbell exercises. You need to use resistance training on your abs similarly to like any other muscle group. But by the way, disclaimer, toes to bar is the most epic way to build abs. I remember when I first started, I couldn't even like lift my legs up. I was like hanging because I got a pull-up bar during quarantine. And that is when I first discovered that I literally couldn't even lift my legs up. Now I'm doing toes to bar and it's just life-changing. So if you really are looking for abs, that is one exercise to just go all in at and just focus on your toes to bar. Not everyone can do that though. So, you know, weighted crunches, things that have resistance is definitely gonna help with the abs. Just saying. This is an honest review and I'm not trying to like offend anyone or, you know, tell everyone to stop doing Orangetheory. In fact, I think you should still do it once or twice a week. I just think that if you wanna see results and have more long-lasting benefits from your workouts that you're doing every day, you should focus on strength training. I also understand that everyone's circumstance is completely different, and what works for me may not work for you. And maybe if it doesn't work for you right now, doesn't mean that years down the road, it won't work for you then. So if you are feeling good with your Orangetheory and it works well for you and that's just what you want to do, you can do that for as long as you want. But if you come to a point where you are ready to spread your wings, see more results, then I would recommend strength training at like a regular gym. I'm like laughing because I'm like, I'm not trying to be negative, but I'm saying something that some people may not agree with. And so it makes me a little nervous. I'm like, oh, like, what do I say? But I am just saying something that I've realized because I've done Orangetheory for such a long period of time. In the beginning, I had my newbie gains. It was great. Never really worked my upper body ever. So then when I started taking the classes, it was awesome. Also struggled with running, so it helped me with that. Definitely gave me a lot of mental strength as far as my running goes. So that's why I say if you're someone who's looking to get into a fitness journey or you haven't worked out in a very long time and you need to get back in shape, start off with Orangetheory for a year or two. But when you're ready to make changes, strength training is where it's at. I hope this helps you guys. It does matter what you're eating. So, you know, tracking your macros is something that has worked really well for me over the years. And I know that tracking your macros isn't something that everyone wants to do, and that's okay. If you guys do Orangetheory, can you please comment below what your thoughts are on everything that I said? Maybe share your experience because it could help someone that's watching this video. Like I said, I know everyone lives a completely different life, and what works for me might not work for you, and my opinion is just my opinion. Anyways, that concludes today's video. Give it a thumbs up because it really supports my channel. Don't forget to subscribe so you never miss another Fitty Freckles video again. Follow me on Instagram, follow me on TikTok, subscribe to my podcast, and I will see you in my next video.